Hi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. We live on a water planet. Roughly 71% of the Earth is covered by water, and it's constantly in motion. Tides surging rhythmically, powerful currents coursing beneath the surface, waves rolling across oceans and crashing against coastlines. The water of the oceans is almost always in motion, hardly ever interrupted. All that motion produces mind-boggling quantities of kinetic energy. The total wave energy resource is the same order of magnitude as world electricity consumption, approximately 2 terawatt. Many companies are developing technologies to convert this inexhaustible energy into electric power without the emission of harmful greenhouse gases. One of the solutions is wave power station. Working principle of wave power station is pretty simple. Enclosed chamber has an opening beneath sea level, which allows water to flow from the sea to the chamber and back. Water level in the chamber rises and falls with the rhythm of the waves. The wave action alternately compresses and decompresses the trapped air, forcing an airflow moving back and forth through a Wells turbine that drives a generator and produces electricity. Main feature of Wells turbine is that the turbine is driven in the same direction by both forward and reverse airflow through the turbine. Even relatively low wave motions can generate enough airflow to keep the turbine moving and to generate energy. As we have already said, the most commonly used air turbine for this application is the Wells turbine. As we also already know, the air is forced forwards and backwards through the turbine and causes the rotation of the turbine. This generates mechanical energy that is converted into electricity by a generator. The Wells turbine has a special feature. It always rotates in the same direction, regardless of which direction the airflow comes from. How is this possible? This is possible because of the symmetrical shape of the rotor blades. As the air hits the rotor blade, most of the flow is deflected in one direction and pushes the blade in the opposite direction. Due to the symmetrical shape of the rotor blades, the same effect happens when the airflow comes from the other direction. Therefore, this Wells turbine always rotates in one direction, regardless of the airflow direction, and guarantees the continuous rotation of the turbine. Important to remember, Wells turbine always rotates in the same direction. Wells turbine also have installed flow controller, with which we regulate airflow through turbine. The Wells turbine must be turned on initially. The airflow alone does not get it to rotate. This turbine is one of the simplest and probably the most economical turbines for wave energy conversion. It does not require rectifying air valves and can extract power at low airflow rate, when other turbines would be inefficient. It has very few moving parts. None of them are in the water, needs no gearboxes, is easy to maintain and achieves an efficiency between 40 and 70%. In this way, we can generate energy with a wave power station, day and night, all year round, as long as there are waves. The world's first 75 kilowatt test wave power station of this kind was put into service as early as November 2000 on the Scottish island of Islay. The commissioning and maintenance of wave power station can be carried out entirely on land, without incurring costs for the use of marine infrastructures or boats. The shorter grid connection to this system is simple and inexpensive, and its environmental impact is minimal or none. I hope that you now know what are benefits of harvesting wave energy. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video, and also watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please consider supporting me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you in the next video.